It's time to turn up the heat on food pathogens. We're talking about cooking. Is it safe? Let's say you plan to make chicken for dinner. Go through the process in your head. You're gonna thaw the chicken if it's frozen. You're gonna keep it separate from other ready-to-eat foods. You're gonna cook it until it's done, and then you'll serve it. But back up to that cooking step. How do you know when it's done? Do you look for the juices to run clear, or check to make sure that the inside is not pink anymore? There's actually only one way to make sure that that chicken you cooked is safe, and that's with temperature. I've got my food thermometer handy while I'm cooking this chicken. When I think it might be done, I put the thermometer in the thickest part at an angle. For foods that are thin or flat, it can be difficult to judge the distance to the middle if you're inserting the thermometer from the top. For this reason, it's easiest to go from the side to get the most accurate reading. If you're cooking something that isn't as straightforward as a chicken breast, make sure that you take the temperature away from things like bone, fat, or gristle to make sure you get the most accurate reading. We've reached 165 degrees Fahrenheit, the safe temperature for poultry. Different foods have different cooking temperatures, including non-meats. Egg dishes, casseroles, and leftovers could make you sick if not heated to the correct temperature. When choosing a thermometer, look for one with a digital display. Digital thermometers can take the temperature of thick or thin foods quickly and accurately. Remember to wash your thermometer with soap and water after each use and dry before putting it away. There's an extra step to this temperature process for whole cuts of beef, lamb, and pork. Have you ever heard of meat resting? It's actually important for food safety as well. While food is resting, the temperature stays constant or rises even further, killing off any remaining harmful bacteria. If you plan to cook food and then serve it over the next several hours, have a way to keep it hot. If you're thinking, what does hot mean? Shouldn't there be a specific temperature I'm looking for? You're right, it's 140 degrees Fahrenheit. Keep it above that level and you'll be safe. Use your food thermometer to check that hot food is at least 140 degrees Fahrenheit. You can have foods out for a little while once they cool down below 140 degrees Fahrenheit, but after 2 hours, it's time to throw it away. With cooler weather and holiday season approaching, it's time to break out those slow cookers. And they're actually really helpful when it comes to food safety as well. Leaving the slow cooker on the warm setting and replacing the lid after serving is an easy way to make sure that your food stays above that 140 degrees Fahrenheit mark. What if you don't want to have to throw that food away after 2 hours? Are you planning to save it as leftovers? Next time, we'll talk about chilling down our food to keep it safe.